Hi, Parag here. We will see how to apply the chalk to kettlebells, and it's very important because as you progress with the heavier weights, if you have a good chalk, then you have a good grip. Unless you really want to train your grip where you can keep a low chalk or probably use the gloves, that's the couple of method. But if you have a good chalk, then probably your performance would get up really to the next level. So we will see step by step process. So there are a couple of things. Either you can have a polished paper or you can have this like a scotch brite which is used in a kitchen. You can cut the polished paper and you can use like a stripe, or you can use a polished paper and you can just clean off whatever is there on the handle first. So we'll do that first. Okay, so just clearing of the handle if there is any burrs or maybe there is any some uneven surfaces. It's very important. Okay, you can apply a chalk to the handle, and you have to apply a force to really get that chalk into the handle, because the key most part is you need to have a good kettlebell at first place, because many kettlebells do not have those abrasions. That's the rough surface, especially competition kettlebells available in the market. So ensure that you first apply one layer of chalk. See, as you can see. You have to apply with a force. So that basically gives you a little even surface all throughout the handle. Okay. Now this will make a little handle a little rough. Now there are a couple of ways. Either you can spray the water on the handle, or you can put it on the palm. Well, I have seen both ways, but I think putting it on the palm really works good. So we'll put it on the palm. You can put it on the handle also, but we'll try with putting it on the palm. Okay, now this is like a little water, and I'm just trying to apply it on the handle. And again, apply the chalk by putting the pressure. You can see the magic of having the kettlebell, having the chalk coming any form on the handle. If you can see that in the video. This is the second layer. You can apply one more layer. As you can see, some of the part is still shiny. And it has to be uniform. Okay, so that looks great to start the grip lifting. Now use as you can see, I have used a big container where if you apply chalk, the chalk really doesn't get on the ground and you really have to collect that back, because you can reuse the chalk, because this chalk actually goes down in the container and you can use the chalk again. So that saves the chalk also. So that was a small tutorial. I wish you good luck in lifting.